So you think rats don't have feelings for their fellow rats? Do you not think so or not? You know, actually, I always pointed this out before. You know, the human species is the only species where you have one human hoards everything and everybody else just goes to hell. You know, you don't see this with like squirrels. You know, you might think of squirrels as, say, tree rats. You know, like they're, you know, in a lot of ways they are. They're tree rats. They're rats. They're kind of like cousins to rats, except they can climb trees really good and they make nests up there in the trees. But do you ever hear of a squirrel that hoards all the acorns in the winter and says, I'm going to sell them back to the other squirrels or else they at a profit or else they starve during the winter? No, you only hear of humans doing that, right? So here's an example of lifeguard rats, you know, rats that save other rats. Here we have a cute little rat with his antenna whiskers out, sensing for any kind of danger for his fellow rats. And here we have a rat going on to a rat experiment who's going to be swimming in the water. So here he goes. You know, one of the cousins goes out there in the water and he's swimming away. And he's like, help, 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 help. I'm getting too deep in water, man. I'm like drowning. Help, help, help. So what they did was they found out that other rats will come to the rescue. They'll come to the rescue and save the other rat. Now, they wanted to find out just how strong this sense of saving the other rat is. So what they did was they offered, you can either take door number A, which is save the rat, or door number B, which is get a treat. Do you know what? The vast majority of times the rats took door number A and they saved the rat first, then they got the treat. Which shows you that rats have empathy and sympathy for their fellow rats. I don't know how good it is in the human species, man. I mean, it doesn't seem to exist in some areas of society, that's for sure. The higher up they go, the more narcissistic they are, right? And here we have the brother rat being saved by the other brother rat or sister rat or brother rats or sisters or sister rat saving sister rat. I don't know if it's male or female. I really can't tell, you know. But maybe you could tell by the length of the tail. I don't know how that works with rats. But anyway, but the thing is, yeah, they can show empathy for their species. They actually do. A lot of people think, you know, hey, it's dog eat dog in the animal world. They're just like, ooh. No, man. You never hear of, like, you know, some species of one animal stealing all the food and, like, you know, one bear is hibernating in the woods. And he's like, I'm going to steal all the food and let all the other bears freaking serve me and pay me back with interest unless I give them enough food so they can hibernate or whatever the hell it is, you know. Come on. They don't do that kind of stuff. Only people do that kind of stuff, right? Well, and actually, Mark Twain actually observed this. You know, so here we have Wall Street, so the home of the biggest rats in the world. You know, we always talk about Washington, D.C., but you know who controls Washington, D.C.? Wall Street, and here's the big rat himself that, you know, controls the whole damn thing. And he's got the strings on him, and he just holds on to, you know, the other dominions, and, you know, J.P. Morgan, Goldman Sachs, whatever the hell he's, you know, Chase Manhattan, whatever, J.P. Morgan Chase, whatever. You know, Wells Fargo, you know, Deutsche Bank, whatever, man. You know, the whole nine yards. That's really what they do, man. They freaking hoard everything. They're not like the freaking, you know, the species of rats is actually better than humans, man. It's amazing. But we always have the ace in the sleeve because the ace in the sleeve is Putin the cat. Putin the cat is going to take care of them rats in freaking Wall Street. And he's got interplanetary help besides. You know, there's going to be some little DARPA freaking technology coming out at those Wall Street clowns. And the day their days are numbered, man. Putin the cat is going to take care of those rats. And if he needs a little backup, he's always got a hard-ass Rocky the cat. Because hard-ass Rocky the cat means business, man. When Rocky the cat gets pissed off, man, them rats freaking scurry. Ugh, yeah. And I'm talking about the human rats, not the furry rats that save other rat brothers in the water. Because we got the good rats. The good rats are the ones that save other rats in the water. Like these guys right here, man. You know, hey, man, we're back here on dry land. Thanks for saving me. I was drowning. I was drowning. I was in the water. I was drowning. I was like, and then you came along and you saved me and now we're on dry land. So, you know, that's a real upright, righteous rat with a tail and fur. Then you got the other clowns that are over there in Wall Street. So Putin the cat is going to take care of those damn things. I'll tell you that right now. He's got some interplanetary help, like I told you. Wall Street is going down. That big rat is going to get the freaking Darth Nader, Putin the cat, ray from the flying saucer, the purple flying flosser coming from the Palladian star system, because Putin the cat has got all that stuff at his command. And on the underground, freaking revolutionary types like we got Rocky. Rocky will freaking clean up whatever's left. Because Rocky's got that look of determination, man. I can tell you that right now. You don't mess with Rocky the cat. Rocky the cat knows his stuff, man. He keeps them claws sharp and long. So anyway, and you can tell that's a no-nonsense face, right? So Wall Street rats, which is Wall Street rats, not rat rats. Rat rats are good. Wall Street rats, beware. And, you know, it's just so damn interesting that you never think that in the animal world, they actually care for each other more than sometimes people do. Is that not amazing? Is that not amazing? They actually show compassion for each other. They actually show that they'll go out of their way to rescue them first, their fellow rat, a rat that they don't even know that's in the water, that's drowning, before they go out and get some treats for some more money or something like that. If that was Wall Street guy, that was anybody over there, they'd look the other way and they'd be grabbed the money and say, I didn't see nothing, right? That's what they would do. So have some respect for the furry rats with the tails, and kind of shows up that the furry rats and the tails are heads and shoulders above the rats in Wall Street. Man, it's freaking sad to say, but that's just how it is, man. Actually, I can tell you the truth. Mark Twain actually freaking observed this. Only humans hoard stuff and make others starve. Only humans do that kind of stuff. Animals don't do that kind of shit. You know, why are they animals and why are we humans? I don't know. Don't make sense, does it?